It's very strange, Mr. Bentley. We still can't find any reason for the alarm to be going off.
Well, in that case, there's only one explanation. It was a ghost.
A ghost?
Come on, you two. There are no such things as ghosts.
But Mr. Bentley said that was the only explanation.
Oh, I'm sorry, Lofty. That was just a joke.
We'll have to leave the alarm off and stay here to see if we can find out what can be triggering it.
I'd be happy to patrol the rear of the town hall, Bob.
Thank you, Mr. Bentley. Wendy and I will stay inside. And Lofty, you and Dizzy watch the front of the building. OK, team?
Oh, yes!
Yes, sir, Bob, sir.
Oh.
Don't worry, Lofty. If we do see any ghosts, I'll keep you safe.
OK, then.
There's definitely no problem with the wiring on these sensors.
We'd better check the rest of the building, then.
Look! What was that? Is that a ghost?
No, that's just an owl, Lofty.
Phew. That's okay, then.
At least I think it was.
What?
I'd better check the side of the building. I'll only be a minute.
Okay. There's no such thing as ghosts. There's no such thing as... Oh, hurry up, Dizzy. She'll be back in a minute. That's only 60 seconds. 59, 58, 57.
Hmm.
30, 29, 28.
Lofty, it's me, Dizzy.
Oh,
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to scare you. Are you okay?
All clear here. Better see how Lofty and Dizzy are getting on.
That's it. Just breathe slowly. In and out. In and out. Oh, it's just you, Mr. Bentley. Oh, are you okay, Lofty?
Well, we've checked the rest of the building, so the answer must be in Mayor Madison's office.
Huh?
Oh, ah! Do you have an official weather forecaster for the event, Bob? After all, wind or rain could ruin the sculptures. I'd be happy to...
Could I do that, Bob? I've got a new weather app on my phone.
Of course you can, Leah. You're now our official weather forecaster.
And what does it say about today's weather, young man?
According to this, the forecast for Spring City is excellent.
Great. But make sure you keep checking in case it changes, Leo.
Yes, Bob.
Welcome, everyone, to the Sand Sculpture Competition. This year's theme is Under the Sea. And I can't wait to see all your amazing creations. Let the sculpting begin!
You can wash your hands at the tap over there, Mayor.
Ah.
Come on!
It looks like fun, doesn't it, Wendy?
We've got an extra sand mould and plenty of sand.
Yeah.
What's the weather forecast, Leo?
Still sunny, Mr. B.
Oh?
No! My ring!
What's that, Madam Mayor?
My ring! It's fallen off! Have to find it, Mr. Bentley!
Don't worry, Mayor Madison. I'm sure we'll find it.
We must! I have to return it to the museum tomorrow. That ring's priceless! I was standing next to Scoop when he made the sand blocks, so it must be in one of the sculptures.
I don't mind looking through our sculpture. As long as there's enough time to build them again.
If people really don't mind.
Let's find that ring, everyone.
I'm sorry, everyone, but I was sure it would be in one of the sculptures. What is it, Jenny? Have you remembered something?
Only that I saw you wearing the ring after we started sculpting, so it couldn't be in a sand block.
Then it's lost! Gone! Forever! I suppose I'd better tell the museum. Please cancel my appearance at the ball, Mr. Bentley.
Hang on, I've got something at home that I'm certain will find your ring. Madam Mayor, you shall go to the ball. Carry on sculpting, everyone.
Will we have time to rebuild our sculptures, Bob?
Of course, Brandon. Wendy, Scoop and I just have to make new sand blocks first.
What are all these plants for, Bob?
I'm using them to build the ship's rudder. You use the ship's wheels to move the rudder and steer the ship.
You know a lot about ships for a landlubber.
What are you doing there, sailor?
I'm varnishing the hull to help it stay waterproof.
Ah, yes, of course. We wouldn't want the old girl sinking. She's been through a lot.
Fascinating.
Perhaps you'd like some help from your captain.
Well...
You missed a spot.
Huh?
Just there. Oh, and another one over there.
Oh.
And just above your head.
I think that perhaps Lofty could use a hand lifting the anchor.
Excellent idea.
Phew.
Steady there, sailor. Your captain's coming to help.
Thanks, Mr. Captain Bentley, sir.
Now, the anchor should go on the starboard side of the bow.
The what side of the which?
Nautical terms, Lofty. To do with ships. The starboard side is the right side of the ship.
Eh?
And the bow is the front of the ship.
What?
Got that?
No.
Off we go.
No, I haven't got it at all. Where am I supposed to be going? Sorry, Bob.
What happened?
I think I got my front and back and sides confused.
Here, lower the anchor to me and I'll attach it to its chain.
Right, Lofty, let's practice those nautical terms, shall we?
Maybe later, Mr. Captain Bentley. I think Leo might need your help.
Ah, yes, and that reminds me, I have something for Leo.
Oh, thank goodness for that.
Ahoy there, Leo!
Huh?
Here's something to make this vessel look just like she did back in the old days. The flag of Captain Horatio Fixham. I hand-stitched it myself. Climb up to the crow's nest and fix it to the mainmast, will you?
I'm not sure I'm supposed to go up there.
Captain's orders.
Okay. Aye, aye, Captain.
Man overboard!
Got you! Phew.
What were you doing up there?
Mr. Bentley wanted me to fly a flag from the mast.
I see.
Then watch this.
The skate bowl? Leo, wait!
Oh, no! How do I stop?
Shit! Oh, no!
Are you okay, Leo?
Yes, thanks, Wendy. I'm fine. But what about the skate bowl?
Oh, no!
It's ruined!
And so's our video.
Oh, sorry. I shouldn't have gone into the bowl on my first day of skating.
Wait a minute. This was your first day, Lightning Leo.
Sort of. Maybe. Yes.
Not to worry, Rockets. I think I know what we can do with that fresh load of cement.
Prize, it's time to vote for the winner. Leo or me?
Dizzy, the wickedest thing on four wheels is definitely you. You should be in the video.
Are you serious? Thanks, Leo. Maybe you could film it with your camera thingy.
Done it without you, Dizzy.
Or without Leo's extra camera work.
Right, anyone up for some more skateboarding?
Bring it on! No!
Wendy, I think Leo needs a few more lessons. Right, team, we're ready to start digging the foundations for the skyscraper.
We're going to dig a deep hole about the size of three school buses stacked up.
So, where are the buses?
Instead of actual buses, we're going to use my laser measure. It'll tell us when we've got to the right depth. Look, Scoop is exactly 5.63 metres away from me.
Hey! How far's that then?
That's about half a school bus long.
And this empty tea mug is exactly 9 centimetres deep. Hold on, team. It's Mayor Madison calling. I'd better answer this.
I love digging new ground. It's all fresh and new and ready to be scooped.
And I can't wait to get stuck into all that muck.
No machine can dig faster and deeper than me.
Hey, I bet I can clear the earth away quicker than you can dig it.
Oh, we'll soon see about that.
Ready to load me up?
Ready!
All
right!
Hold your horsepower, you two. Wait for Bob's signal.
Oh!
Well, we can certainly try.
Hello, Mayor Madison.
Oh, hello, Wendy! I was just saying to Bob, we can't afford to hang about on this one. I want to see that skyscraper pronto.
You can't exactly rush a skyscraper, Mayor. You have to dig down before you can build up.
Great!
Ah, so the mayor stopped us digging to tell us to hurry up with the digging.
Did you hear that, Muck? That is a direct order from Mayor Madison to
get digging!
Let the challenge begin!
Yes, Mayor Madison, we're digging.
Okay. Let's take a break, everyone.
Oh, we were only just getting going.
Why are people always taking breaks? Us machines don't need to.
Then there's only one way.
I just wanted to have fun on the snow like everyone else.
Maybe I could make it up to you by building you a really big jump.
Yes, please. That would be totally
extreme.
like a plan, Scoop. We'll set up the night skiing lights while you build the jump. Let's go!
In a mirror.
Hey, super snowboarding, Bob. You caught some big air up there.
Thanks, Guy. Maybe winter's not so bad after all. Although I am still looking forward to summer.
Great. Then I can teach you how to water ski.
Right. That does sound very wicked.
Nothing could go wrong.
Maybe you would like an ice cream.
Window, Bob.
Excellent. Okay, everyone, we need to get those penguins into their new pool as soon as possible.
Can we
fix it?
Yes, we can.
Whistle,
what's that thing?
What's going on here? Who is responsible for this disgrace?
Oh, this outrageous
circus! I'm so sorry. Fiasco, Miss Knight.
Rock-uppers?
Excuse me.
Rock-uppers!
Penguins!
Extraordinary!
Penguin.
You appear to have missed one, Scoop.
Oh, not that way.
Yes.
No!
Stay away from the drive!
Up with you now that I love penguins!
We can take these penguins back to the zoo.
Whoa!
I'm over there. Hey, get back in that pond. Hands up, Mayor Madison's special guest.
Welcome really to the Flying Saucepan.
Oh, the finest food with the best views in
that's why Mayor Madison has arranged for you to come back to the zoo.
We bite to
and officially open our new penguin pool.
It appears to be moving.
I'd always intended it to be the highlight of your visit.
It's a revolving restaurant.
Oh, yes, please, I'd love that.
Magnificent miracle of mechanical engineering.
What do we want?
Fancy a plate of haggis and meats.
I feel sick.
I now declare Spring City's new Antarctic Penguin Experience well and truly over.
This visit is a complete disaster. I thought you said nothing could go wrong.
This has been the best visit ever.
Maybe you would like an ice cream.
Thank you so much, Mayor Madison. And thank you, Mr. Bentley.
I wish that penguin pool was ready.
That.
And thank you.
This reminds
once
me of
again,
the
time you saved the day.
Wait, what's happening?
Mayor Townley is visiting next week.
Really? I hear me back.
What's going on here? Who is responsible for this disgrace?
Oh, this outrageous
circus! Well, I am.
And you laid it on this wonderful tree. Just for me. Thank you so much.
We like to keep our visitors happy.
Uh-oh. Hi, Bob. Turns out Mayor Madison's special guest really likes penguins.
Oh, right. And that's why Mayor Madison has arranged for you to come back to the zoo. And officially open our new penguin pool.
Exactly. I'd always intended it to be the highlight of your visit.
Oh, yes, please. I'd love that. Marvellous. Well, come on, everybody. What are we waiting for?
Here it goes.
I'm scared already. Let's get this goose delivered and quick.
Lofty, where are you? Oh, I didn't lock the crate.
Oh, super sticky play slime. No, not good enough to trick Bob.
Yes, this is a brilliant trick. It will definitely make Bob jump.
So, what happens at these trail stops?
Guests put their hand in the hay and pull out either a trick or a treat. Why don't you have a go? Find anything?
Yes! A Halloween cookie! What a great treat!
But I don't understand. You should have... Oh.
More noises? Who's there?
Okay, no one. Only me.
I'm a ghost! I'm not scared.
Doesn't make Bob jump, nothing will. Hey, Bob! Why don't you take a turn at this trail stop?
What's this I found?
A toffee apple! Another treat! Wow!
I don't get it. The spider was supposed to...
This entrance is going to be cool!
Oh, Wendy! Your ghost is here! You need to help me!
Oh dear.
What's that?
It looks like a ghost!
We did it! It's not over yet, Lofty. We need to hurry and get the park finished. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
Madison, we're almost ready for your visit to Dino Park.
Excellent, Bob. I'm so looking forward to seeing it.
As am I. The beasts of the Cretaceous era are a special interest of mine.
Especially our prized Triceratops. The Riverdale models don't move, you know.
Oh, sorry. I've forgotten something. Just wait 2 minutes.
Okay, guys, we're done.
Not quite.
Huh?
What?
Why is it not making any noise?
The fool must have broken its roar.
And the mayor is here. There's no time to fix it.
Wait! I know someone who can make a good roaring noise.
Who's that then?
Sorry to keep you waiting.
No problem, Bob. I'm just glad you finished the park in good time. Shall we? Oh, very impressive. Oh, that's brilliant. Fantastic! Ooh. Isn't it meant to make a sound?
Ooh? Yes, well, I'm not certain Triceratops would have sounded like that.
It sounded very realistic to me.
Well, that pretended to be a dinosaur.
Where did Scoop and Lofty go? Were you scared?
Maybe just a little.
I wasn't. I was, helping Lofty.
Ah! Get out! Get out! Oh, it's flopping about!
Watch out, Scoop! Slow down!
Oh, thank goodness it's gone.
What's going on?
Oh, I'm going to fall in!
It's okay, Lofty. You're not going to fall. Stay calm. Slowly drive forwards.
It's not working.
None of Lofty's wheels are touching the ground, Bob.
What are we going to do?
It's a shame we can't just reel him in like a fish.
Hang on a minute. That gives me an idea. Lofty, don't move. Just do exactly what I say. Scoop, come forward really slowly so that your front bucket is below Lofty's hook. Lofty, let your hook drop so Scoop can carry it. Wendy, Leo, go with Scoop and attach Lofty's hook to the base of the spar.
Help!
You'll be fine, Lofty.
Ready, Bob?
Okay, stand back now. Start pulling your hook in really slowly. That's it, you're doing fine. And now, drive forward very gently. Yeah! Well done, Lofty.
Thank you, Bob. I'm sorry, Lofty. I shouldn't have been messing about by the river. I put Lofty in danger and we've lost part of the bridge. The race will be ruined now.
Don't worry, Scoop. You helped put things right too.
Did I?
Yes. You said we should reel Lofty in like a fish, and that's exactly what we did.
Except Lofty hasn't got ugly teeth and spikes down his back.
We'll get the bridge finished in time if we all work together. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
I should just try to get some rest. Must get some sleep. Maybe I should try counting sheep. Oh no, they're boring. I'll try tires. One, two. What is that smell? Yikes! Double yikes! A real emergency!
Nearly there, Bob. We don't want all this lovely ice cream melting.
Nearly there, Chef Tutty.
Bob, it's Scoop! It's an emergency!
Another one, Scoop? Did you get some rest?
No, but there's a fire, Bob! A fire in the yard!
Look, Scoop.
You need to to get rest. Otherwise, you're going to keep on exaggerating these small problems.
B-b-b-b-
rest, Scoop. Over and out.
Ah! Got to save the yard. But what do I do? Oh, I can pick it up because I'm made of metal. So, if Bob won't come to the fire, I'll have to take the fire to Bob. He'll know how to put it out.
Got some amazing types of ice cream here, Chef Tete.
Thank you. I invented them myself.
Do people prefer the pizza flavour to the sardine and spinach flavour?
We'll never know, Lofty, if we don't get them in the freezer soon. They'll melt.
Fire! Fire! Scoop!
Okay, try not to panic, Scoop. Drop it onto the sand. Get back, everyone!
But this is a real, real emergency! But I must put the fire out! Oh, the sea's too far away! Oh, I got it!
Great idea, Scoop! Quick, Muck, coffee scoop!
Will do, Bob!
Well done for putting the fire out, Scoop. But you should never pick something up that's on fire.
I know, Bob, but I was so tired and confused.
Still, I should have listened to you when you said it was an emergency.
Yeah, but I should never have exaggerated so much. I'll never, ever, ever exaggerate again in my whole life, ever.
What's done is done. You saved the yard, and luckily, only the roof's ruined.
What about the ice cream? In half an hour, it'll be completely melted.
Half an hour, you say? We can do that.
So you can fix this?
Yes, we can!
Gentlemen, start your engines! Ready? Steady? Go!
Yes! It's like skyscraper! Never give up! Nothing can stop me now!
What have you done this time?
I'm sorry, Bob. I just wanted to be like Sky and break a record.
Well, you definitely broke something.
Oh, dear. The fun run starts in an hour, and we haven't even finished the rope bridge.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
The game's not over just yet, team. We can fix this if we draw on our best abilities. Lofty, I'll need your amazing weightlifting strength.
Sure thing, Bob.
And Muck, I'll need your powerful bucket.
No sweat.
What's wrong, Scoop?
Oh, I messed up everything for Sky's fun run. And I wasn't very good at sports either.
And Scoop?
Yes, Bob?
You're an all-round all-star. I'll need your speed, ability and digging power.
Yes, Bob?
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
The most important thing about a fun run is to have fun! And eat your broccoli. Go! Yeah.
the train.
But how?
Warning received, loud and clear. Applying brakes now.
I put the team in danger, all because I couldn't concentrate on one job at a time.
You managed it in the end.
And saved the train.
But what are we going to do about the station and the track?
There's just enough time before the train makes its first journey. So, can we fix it?
Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
To be a real cowboy and round up those horses.
And they're in top gear.
Don't worry, I grew up with horses. Here's what we're going to do. Lofty, extend your crane arm as far as you can and as fast as you can. We're going to make a barrier and steer them back into their paddock.
Grew up with horses, Wendy.
Oh, yes, I rode them all the time. Wooden ones on the merry-go-round.
Huh?
Well, Bob, that was smart work getting my horses back. I hope you've got another good idea about how to get them into these stables before dark.
There's nothing for it but hard graft and starting over. We'll get them rebuilt, even if it takes all night.
Oh, Muck. I've let everybody down. The stables would be finished by now if I hadn't scared the horses. A real cowboy would never do that. If only there was something I could do to make up for it.
Right, here's the plan. Wendy and Lofty will stay on site with me to rebuild the stables. Leo, you can take Scoop and Muck back to their garages. At least some of us can get a good night's sleep.
Even if the horses don't. All that galloping and now nowhere for them to sleep. Oh, they'll be too tired to even walk around the track tomorrow.
Nowhere for them to sleep. Hang on, Bob. Yeah? No, Pilchard, it's not for you.
Good night, Buck.
Night, Lord.
sleep tight. Make sure your brakes on right.
Thank you for giving up your bays for the night.
You were right, Leo. Our machine bays are just like horse stables, just bigger.
Yep. Three bays for three tired horses. Three buckets of oats and three buckets of water. I feel like a real cowboy now.
Yeah. Look at us all sleeping under the stars. It's just like the Wild West.
Well done, Cowboy Leo. You made that into a real Wild West roundup.
Horses will sleep well in their new stables tonight. Have a problem. The parachute is torn and there isn't a spare.
Stella can't go into space without her parachute, otherwise she won't be able to come back home safely.
Bob, I think I know how to fix it.
Lofty, really carefully, please. Well done, Lofty. Let's get over to Mission Control.
Now.
There!
Yay! It was a great idea to use the banner to patch the parachute, Lofty. You saved the launch and Stella's coming down in a safe area, just like I planned.
Well done, Lofty. Well done, May.
Thank you, Bob. Stella's a record breaker.
If you feel like breaking another record, May, could you build a rocket so I can be the first crane into outer space?
Lofty,
the space crane.
Interesting proposal. Let's see. Yes, I could.
This is such a great start for a kiosk, Chef Patty.
Thanks,
Thanks, Lofty. You know, today is going to be the hottest day of the year. So I was wondering, Bob, if you'd be able to get it built by this afternoon, as everyone would be desperate for an ice cream.
What do you think, team? Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
Was someone to play with.
Hey, Pigeon! You want to hang out? Oh, we'll play a game together! Okay, not sure I know this game.
Is it a copying game?
Shall I copy you? Pigeon? Oh, you fancy a different game? Pigeon!
Oh, I wish I was at the beach with everyone else.
For time, Bob. Folks will be wanting their ice cream soon.
We're well on schedule, Chef Tutty.
Scoop to Bob. Come in. Over.
Bob here. Over.
Hi, Bob. A bit of a situation here back at the yard.
Go on.
We've got a dripping hose.
Go on.
Well, that's it.
Scoop, we really need to finish the kiosk.
So I think the dripping hose can wait. But thanks for telling me and try to get some rest. Bye, Scoop.
Oh! The only thing is,
it's dripping quite fast, and I'm just worried that the whole yard might get flooded.
I mean, can Pilchard swim if it's an emergency?
Right. Better safe than sorry. I'll head straight back. Muck, I need a lift back to the yard. Sorry, Chef Tutty. Won't be long. Perhaps that wasn't quite an emergency, Scoop. It was a bit of an exaggeration to say the yard was going to flood.
Well, it was pretty drippy, so I thought I'd better tell you.
I'd better get back, or we'll be behind schedule on the build. Try to get some rest, Scoop.
OK, Bob.
I know we've just got here, but are you ready to head back to the beach, Muck?
You bit, Bob!
Can't take any more!
That wasn't supposed to happen, was it?
Oops.
The bear's arriving on the next plane. Are you ready? Are you ready? Bob, where did the bear's habitat go?
Don't worry, Jenny. Just a little hiccup with the foundations. Bob will put it right.
What happened, Scoop?
I'm so sorry, Bob. I just wanted to give the big, fierce mountain bear a big, tall mountain to live on so that it would be happy.
Sorry, Bob.
I'm really sorry too, Bob. I should have known better.
No, Lofty, I persuaded you to build it higher. I'm sorry, it really is all my fault.
Jenny's in a panic. I hope you have a backup plan, Bob.
I didn't design the mountain to be as tall as Scoop wanted, but I do like his idea.
Brilliant!
Yes, and?
If we use shingle and concrete as the base instead of shingle and soil, we could build four different levels instead of three. Can you fetch us some quick drying concrete, Two-Ton?
I can bring some now, Bob, before I collect the bear.
Thanks, Two-Ton.
You're very welcome.
And then we'll all have to work extra hard to get it finished.
We will, Bob.
Anything you say.
We can count on us.
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can.
We'll be right back.
everyone.
The tree lights are going to look great, Wendy.
Well, let's test them and see.
Hey, Wendy,
I'm about to start making the snow. Can you help me carry the bottles of fluid?
Sure. I'm all finished here.
Bob is here, and the tree lights are twinkling. This is the perfect time to give him his Christmas present.
Now, Lofty. Oh, you're ruining the display.
But I'm trying to find it.
Lofty, you're in the way.
No, it. Oh, where is it? Never mind. Bob's gone. I'll find it later.
Come on, Bob, let's finish the display.
Is there snow yet?
Not yet. Once the fluid is in, the machines need to be switched on.
Oh, then is there snow?
Not quite. The machines churn up the fluid to make tiny white bubbles that stick together, and that makes the pretend snow.
All done. Do you two want to go down and watch the snow fall over the tree?
Woo-hoo! I'm gonna see it snow!
I think that's a yes from Leo.
The display is almost finished and I've still not given Bob his present.
We're gonna test the snow machines! Are you coming to work?
Oh yeah, sure am.
Definitely!
I'll be there in a minute.
Oh, Lofty, please don't mess up the display again.
I won't.
I'd love to give Bob his Christmas present when it's actually snowing. Where is it?
But look what I've done to the rocket.
Looks like that's the end of D11D.
Hooray!
Sorry.
And the end of my film.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry.
Better?
I'm okay, except I'll never see Space Robots 3. And nor will anyone else.
Unless we can think of a way to fix D11D.
We build an all-new D11D. D12D.
I'm afraid a new robot would take months to build rather than hours.
What about if we clean up D11D, put him on wheels, and move him around with ropes?
Except the audience will see the ropes, and that's not a good look for a space robot.
Oh, poor Safi. Now she's never going to meet her robot hero.
Hey, wait a minute. Safi can do the D11D noises perfectly.
And she's about the same size. Are you thinking what I'm thinking, Leo?
I think so, Bob.
Wendy, can you get the rocket back up and the set in shape? If Leo and I sort out the D11D problem.
With the help of these guys,
I can.
In that case, there's only one thing to say. Action! Great scene.
But what nobody knew is that something strange lurked in the woods.
Then what happens, Leo?
I can see a campfire!
Come up, Leo!
It rumbled and grumbled in the darkness. It had eyes so big and bright they could blind you. And a cry so terrifying that it could turn your hair white overnight.
I don't like the sound of that.
Just be silly, Muck. Put your lights on if you're scared.
Ooh. Ooh. Ah.
Please let go of my hand. Both of you.
I was just trying to make you feel safer.
I think we should stay here till the lights have gone.
Shall I hold your hand, Leo?
Bob up. Oh, wake up!
Oh, now what?
Wake up!
Bob, we did something silly.
And we've lost Dizzy.
We're really sorry, Dizzy.
We didn't realise you weren't with us until we got back to the yard.
Are you okay, Dizzy?
I'm fine, but he isn't.